Looking into the idea of ancient aliens here on Earth is a subject that I've approached numerous times. The idea that an alien race came here, settled, and some say never left, endures. But as we make our own way out into the universe, we are coming across problems we could have never imagined. Problems any species not native to a planet would need to overcome. This can be projected onto the idea of ancient alien founders of this planet, as well as provide us with an idea of the challenges that face us if we are serious about becoming a multi-planetary species. So, what does it take, how close are we, and how does this relate to extraterrestrials on planet Earth? Let's take a look. Welcome to IF, videos on history, mystery, and the strange. Hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you never miss a video again. When we travel is most often with family and friends. The logistics of organizing group trips can be stressful and often filled with challenges. All this stress is most commonly for a relatively short journey. Now imagine if you had to travel billions of light years across the universe. Who would you choose to travel with? And do you think you could organize every little thing that would ensure you and your group's survival? With 2020 being such an eventful year, as a species we should be looking at a way in which we can ensure our long-term survival. The surefire way of this is to expand our civilization out into the stars. This has long been the idea of science fiction, but today it is rapidly becoming a reality. Humanity is being threatened with extinction due to many factors, man-made and natural. And at some point in our future, we will face some extinction-level, cataclysmic event. The only possible way the end of the world would not mean the end of humanity would be for us to settle on another planet or planets. And some say we should be looking at doing this within a short period of time. If we need to leave Earth, we really need to seriously look at the feasibility of man's survival on another world and see if this could be achieved with a small group of brave human pioneers. The movie The Martian and the book on which the film is based approaches the practical difficulties of being trapped on a world that is not conducive to life. With a grounding in real science, it does provide some interesting solutions to the problems humans would face, but being a work of fiction, it does take a few liberties with the truth at times. In the vein of the movie, a professor, Jean-Marc Salotti, from France's Bordeaux Institute National Polytechnic, was inspired by Carl Sagan's book, Pale Blue Dot, A Vision of the Human Future in Space, and Elon Musk's plan to build a 100-person Mars spacecraft to investigate the minimum number of people needed to escape an inevitable future Armageddon-level event. In his paper published in Scientific Reports, Salotti starts by making the simple yet necessary assumption that 110 people could do more than one task and share activities. This group of settlers would need to be highly skilled in a number of different disciplines, and if you had to choose who to take, you would need people skilled in tasks involving lifting, carrying, placement, driving, navigation, climbing, medicine, and construction, to name a small number of areas essential for human survival. So, let's say you have your buddies or team in place. Now we must approach the practical needs of fuel. That's fuel for both machinery and people. It could be a good idea to take a farmer. If there is some type of soil, then it could be manipulated to enable the planting of and growing of crops on an alien world. There would need to be some local resources available, a resource that can be used as an energy source. It could be in many different forms, a gas, mineral, or liquid present on the surface of the planet. Whatever type of resource is available, its exploitation needs to be possible so the first settlers of a new world can extract useful chemical elements. Energy is the universal need for all things. Without energy or a way of creating it, it would be pointless to try and settle a world. One of the biggest problems faced during space travel are the energy costs of space flight. Other more specific chemical elements, if found on another planet, would make survival far easier, such elements as water, oxygen, and others. If these basic elements are missing, they will need to be produced from local resources, or they will have to be produced from the exploitation of the available elements on the planet. This then brings us onto the logistics of production capacity. Production capacity is defined by the number of items that can be produced, the cost in terms of energy for the items, and the feasibility and cost effectiveness to produce a needed object. The importance of these items regarding survival for a given period. It may be nice to use the time and energy to craft a nice comfy chair, but if that comes at the cost of not producing a much needed tool, then it would have to be skipped in favor of the tool. For settlers of a new planet, the capacity must reach an acceptable threshold, allowing survival and development of the newly founded settlement. If we assume that the planet has been previously scouted to ensure that it has the necessary resources to keep the ship's crew alive and allowing enough in terms of resources to build temporary structures to hold and house everyone, this being a temporary measure as slowly, more permanent buildings and an infrastructure are completed, the energy for the machines and buildings being easy to obtain compared to the energy that is needed for humans. A solution to keeping settlers fed will involve the gathering or growing of food. Rations like MREs, meals ready to eat, would keep people going for a short time, but humans have a high calorie need, so a solution to the food problem would be a priority. There is the possibility of robots terraforming before the arrival of human settlers, but that is a whole new technology that we could investigate in another video. Let me know if that's something you would like to see. Saloti goes on with his view of the ideal team and plan to settle another planet. He defines 5 essential tasks to help you or the captain pick out the right friends to bring: ecosystem management, air water agriculture, energy production and industry, especially extracting minerals and manufacturing, building, construction and landlords, and social activities, healthcare, daycare, education, entertainment and more. Time for you to update your friends list, and remember, everyone needs to be a multitasker. He then goes on to say, the minimum number of settlers has been calculated and the result is 110 individuals. Other assumptions can be made. The proposed method allows assessments and comparisons, opening the debate for the best strategy for survival. If this relatively low number is confirmed, survival on another planet might be easier than expected, providing that the organization of the settlers is appropriate. History can provide us with many examples when small groups set off to remote areas to found a society and for said society to collapse, often into violence, poverty and disease. An important part of the successful founding of a new society is the group dynamic and the relationships within the community. Could the TV provide us with another ideal group or unit? Lost in Space takes the classic Swiss Family Robinson story of a family stranded on a desert island and having to pull together to survive and projects it into space. The show originally aired in the 60s, but thanks to Netflix, got a reboot in 2019. The 2019 version saw the Robinsons featured as one cell of a bigger populace, which was comprised of family units. This idea was clever for the show and its storyline, but it is also applicable to real-world scenarios. The bonds that keep a family together are strong and may just be the factor which pushes the founding group of a new civilization on another planet to push past their limits and ensure humanity gains a foothold in the universe outside of our current home. If you were chosen for a voyage beyond the stars and the fate of humanity was resting on your shoulders, how many of your friends and family would you take? Who would you choose and why? Let me know in the comments below. As always, if you like what I do here on the channel, hit that red button, like and share. You can catch the latest by searching We Are If. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.